Hi, in this video we continue our investigation of mixtures of logit models. So far, we have investigated model specifications that included error components in the utility functions. In this video, we will look at how to include random parameters to model test heterogeneity. Let's consider a specification with two alternatives, I and J. And here I have two variables, T and C. So you can think about it as travel time and travel cost in a context of a transportation mode choice. And I use a specification where the error terms are IID extreme value, so it's a logit model. I would like to model test heterogeneity. What does it mean? Let's take one parameter, beta T, for example. I would like to relax the assumption that this beta T is the same for everybody, for all members of the population. Some people have a stronger feeling of travel time than others, and I would like to model it. The idea is the following. I will assume that beta, instead of being a fixed value, is distributed in the population. And then I will just assume a distribution. In this case, I have assumed a normal distribution. I will assume that the beta t is distributed with a normal distribution with a mean beta bar t and a variance sigma t square. So another way to write it would be to say that beta t is equal to beta bar t, which is the mean, plus sigma t times xi, with xi being distributed as a normal 0, 1. Why do I do that? Well, remember, when we will deal with these mixtures, we will have to generate draws, right? And by doing this, I will separate the parameters that we will have to estimate. In this case, beta bar t and sigma t from the draws. And here we will draw from a normal distribution, which is 0, 1. Let's now plug this value in the specification above. So what we obtain is that ui is equal to beta t bar times ti plus sigma t xi ti plus beta c ci plus nu I. And exactly the same for uj. We have beta t bar tj plus sigma t xi tj plus beta c cj plus nu j. If you compare this specification with the one that we have seen so far, the term that involves the random parameters includes now a variable. While in the previous models that we have seen so far, this was a pure error component that did not involve any variable. But that's the only difference. So everything else applies. Okay? To calculate the choice probability, we will first calculate the choice probability conditional to xi, and this is a logit model. And then we will integrate out xi, and we will have a mixture of logit models, exactly as we did before. So the mechanisms is exactly the same. That's what we have done in this slide. So we assume that nu I and nu j are IID extreme value. First, we assume that xi is given, and therefore, the probability to choose alternative I given xi is given by the logit model. Very simple to write. And now, when we want to calculate the probability of I, we have to integrate out the xi, and we obtain the mixture of logit models, as we have done before. Let's look at an example. I'm using again the Swiss Metro example with the following specification. So I have two constants, one for car, one for train. The constant for Swiss Metro has been normalized to zero. I have a generic cost coefficient. I have a generic frequency coefficient for the public transportation alternatives. And I have a travel time coefficient. And now I will assume that beta time, the coefficient for travel time, is randomly distributed across the population. As I did in the previous slide, I will assume a normal distribution, and I'm calculating the integral using Monte Carlo integration with 1,000 draws. In this table, I first report the results of a logit model, where the beta time parameters is assumed to be fixed. It's the same for everybody in the population. I use it as a benchmark. And then I estimate a random coefficient model where beta time is assumed to be distributed following a normal distribution. And then this is what I denoted by beta bar t in the previous slide. And this is what I denoted by sigma t in the previous slide. So there is one comment that we can already make is that the fit, the value of the final log likelihood, has improved a lot. And this is actually typical when you use mixtures of logit in general and random coefficients in particular. As soon as you model the distribution of them, you may experience a very significant improvement of the fit. But it does not necessarily mean that you have a better model. And let's look more carefully at the results of this model. Actually, I will reject this model. I will not like it. Let's try to understand why. Well, to understand why, we need to look at the estimated results of the distributed coefficient. We have a coefficient, beta t, which is distributed following a normal distribution with mean minus 2.26 and variance 1.66 squared. That's what the estimation result provided. So let's plot this distribution to see what it means. This is it, okay? So this is the bell-shaped PDF of the normal distribution for the time coefficient. And there is something that annoys me with this. What is it? Well, remember, we are modeling here the time coefficient. And from a behavioral point of view, we assume that the utility of an alternative will decrease as the travel time increases. It means that we expect the sign of the coefficient to be negative. But if you look at the distribution here, you see that there is a significant portion of the distribution that corresponds to a positive value. This section here represents the proportion of the population which is associated with a positive coefficient. And if you calculate this integral here, you get something like about 8.8%. So this model associates 8.8% of the population with a positive coefficient. Well, you may argue that it's a behavioral phenomenon that you observe here. Well, I would argue, on the contrary, that it's just a feature, a mathematical feature of the model that you postulate. In particular, a normal distribution has infinite support, so every value has a non-zero probability, and it's also symmetric. It means that if you have several people in your population who have a very negative beta, well, you have to compensate them by some people who have a very positive beta, right? Because the distribution is symmetric. And therefore, what we observe here may simply be an artifact of the fact that you have selected a normal distribution. My assumption here is that the normal distribution is not a correct assumption to model a beta coefficient that must be negative. Okay, so if I go back to the results, so the reason I would like to reject this model is because the probability that the beta time coefficient is non-negative is quite high. It's about 9%. So what do I do? I reject this model, but what do I use? Well, I should actually impose the beta coefficient to be negative. I select the distribution. I do whatever I want. So I will select a distribution where the support of the distribution is in the negative number. And a natural way to do it would be to use a log normal distribution. A log normal distribution has a positive support. Right? So if I change the sign, I will have a negative support. And by design, I will have zero people with a positive beta coefficient. Let's do that. So I have the same specification here. I have also the beta time, which is randomly distributed. But the difference with the previous model is that I use a log normal distribution. How do we model a log normal distribution? Well, the idea here would be to do the following. Let's keep this assumption that beta t is normally distributed with parameters beta hat and sigma t square. But then, in order to enforce the positivity, I calculate the exponential of beta t. So this is, by definition, always non-negative. And this is distributed as a log normal distribution with the two parameters. And in my specification of the utility function, I will write ui equals e to the beta t times ti plus beta c ci plus nu I, and the same for uj, e to the beta t tj plus beta c cj plus nu j. Okay, but if I do that, it doesn't work because the coefficient of t is positive due to the exponential. Well, that's not a big deal. I just change the sign here. And in this case, I have a specification where, by design, the coefficient of the travel time will be negative. And this will address the issue that I had with the previous model that didn't impose that a priori assumption that I have, that the beta time coefficient should be negative. Now we have a little interpretation to make here. So the expectation and the variance of the log normal distribution is not directly obtained from the parameters themselves. The expectation of beta t would be e to the beta t bar plus sigma t squared divided by 2. And similarly, the variance of the parameter e to the beta t would be e to the 2 beta bar t plus sigma t squared times e to the sigma t squared minus 1. So I refer you to the theory about log normal distribution to check these formulas. Let's go back to the results. So I am extending my table. I have maintained the logit specification and the random coefficient with the normal distribution on the second column. And now I have this new column for the model that I have just estimated with a random coefficient which is log normally distributed. Well, as you can see first, the fit, the final log likelihood is a little bit lower than this one, but it's still significantly better than the logit one. These are the two parameters that I have estimated. As we just discussed, I cannot interpret them directly. I have to plug them into the equations to obtain the mean and the variance of the log normal distribution. So this is the expectation of e to the beta t, and this is the square root of the variance. And in this case, for this model, the probability that the beta time is greater than zero is zero. By design, we have imposed it. Something that we can notice as well is that the mean value of beta is kind of going away from zero. So for the logit model, we had -1.28. Then for the normal distribution, we had -2.26. And now we have -3.85. Let's look at this on an illustration. Okay, so here I have plotted the distribution. So this is the beta t coefficient. And I have the frequency on the y-axis. So remember, we had the normal distribution, which is represented in red here, where we had a significant portion of the population, which is associated with a positive value of time. And now I have a log normal distribution. And the log normal distribution is represented in blue. As you can see, we have 0% of the population associated with a positive beta coefficient. This is by design. But there is another feature of the log normal distribution that you probably know about, is the fact that it has a heavy tail. So the log normal distribution associates a relatively large probability to extreme values, to very negative values. And again, this is an artifact of the distribution itself. So we'll have to investigate if it is indeed representing some behavioral aspects or not. And as I mentioned before, if we compare the means of these three models, the logit model here, the model with the normally distributed random coefficient, and now the model with the log normally distributed log time coefficient, we see that this is drifting away from zero. Mixtures of logit can also be used to model unobserved test heterogeneity. Some test parameters in the model are assumed to be distributed across the population. We have seen that the choice of the distribution matters, and consistency with behavioral assumptions must be verified.